Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had some stronger seismic activity on the 5th, as you can see on the SGI graph, just following the convergence of critical planetary geometry that we had on the 4th. I discussed that geometry in detail in the previous update. A clustering of stronger seismic events. We anticipated higher 5, borderline 6 magnitude, and that's pretty much what we had. Most of the seismic activity occurred in the Japan area, and we did not have fluctuations, atmospheric fluctuations, indicating Japan. It was actually pretty quiet in the atmosphere as far as we were able to record in the last several days. So what are we going to have in the next couple of days? If we look at the SGI graph, we see a higher lunar peak, that is today, followed by some critical planetary geometry with Mercury and Venus. We see that by the red and purple colors. And if we look at the solar system, we see the 90 degree angle with Mercury involving Earth and Venus, and that can be critical planetary geometry. We also see some lunar geometry involving Mars and Jupiter, and these are 135 degree angles, and that adds to the geometry that we have today. We could see some stronger seismic activity as a result, probably around the 8th, that's tomorrow, give or take one day. It could be later today already, it could be tomorrow or on the 9th, and it is possible that we will see a similar clustering of stronger seismic events, similar to what we saw on the 5th. It is also possible that we're going to have a strong seismic event around mid 6 magnitude, give or take, and again, that could be around the 8th, just following this geometry. It very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, exactly how the seismic response will be to the electromagnetic waves coming from this planetary and lunar geometry. A quick look at the SGI graph also tells us that we're going to have two planetary conjunctions on the 9th and 10th. That will be a convergence, which is probably going to be more critical, but I will discuss that in one of the next updates. We had a couple of fluctuations yesterday, marking the West Pacific. Primarily, this may have to do something with what we had in Japan on the 5th. To the north, we see Kamchatka, the north of Taiwan also, and the Mariana Islands. These are the fluctuations that we had, and possibly also a weak fluctuation West Java and South Sumatra. I'm not sure if that is really significant, but to the north is. And again, this could have to do with the seismic increase that we had in Japan. This is the only fluctuation series that we had. It was yesterday. Other than that, it was relatively quiet. This is the update for now. Until next time.